Okay, another series and a video that's guaranteed to be two games or fewer. That's because this one's already up to game five in the series, where the Phoenix Coyotes, I have them the correct size, are ahead of the Ottawa Senators 3-2. Game six is in Ottawa. At the time, let's see, it wouldn't have been called Carell anymore. It would have been the Ottawa Arena, Scotiabank Place. That's what it was called. I have this just off to the side here. There's some things I figured I would just read off rather than sit here and on and try to go on memory. So it's in Ottawa, where the Ottawa Senators, I think actually both Ottawa and Phoenix played six playoff games. No, seven for Phoenix in 2010. The Senators were led by Matt Cullen. I took one look at that and went, oh yeah, he was a Senator. Daniel Alfredsson actually tied Cullen in points. Cullen had one more goal. Jason Spezza right in behind them, as was Erik Karlsson, with 6 points in six games. Chris Kelly also had 6 points in six games, a goal and five assists. You had Mike Fisher with 5 points then, a still youngish, fairly upstart Mike Fisher. Chris Neal had 3 goals in six games. Yarker Ruutu played for this team. Chris Campoli, Anton Volchenkov, Jonathan Chychu, over from San Jose, saw a single game of playoff action in this one for Ottawa, where the Senators also had a Sharks veteran Milan Mihalik as well for this one. Some Sharks stars, really, from a few seasons earlier. The Senators, of course, had Chris Phillips, and of course, he didn't have any points registered. They went back and forth with a tandem of Elliott and LeClaire. Can't recall in which order, but that season, those were the two netminders they relied on in the playoffs, where the Coyotes went exclusively with Breeze Galov, and they were led in scoring that year, 7 games in the playoffs. So both of these teams were eliminated in round one. One of them will get a chance in this one to go to the second round, with this being the 2010 all playoffs. So I guess I probably could have put that there as well. And Wojtek Wolski, who 4 goals and 5 points in 7 games, and he and Lee Stempniak, who also played for Phoenix in the playoffs. Stempniak just had a couple of assists in 7 games. Wolski was second on the team in scoring, second to Matthew Lombardi, with 4 goals and 5 points in 7 games. And both he and Stempniak came over. Stempniak especially, he played 18 games with Phoenix that season. He had a point per game, did Stempniak, and he had 14 goals among them. So he had 14 goals and 18 points in like 18 games. I was just going over some stuff last night, and then again this morning. So I was tempted to play this out last night as well, right after Boston and Chicago. So I started looking. Shane Doan only appeared in a few games in the playoffs. I will assume that that's injury shortened. Derek Morris had a goal and 4 points. Radim Vrbata, 2 goals and 4 points. Keith Yandle, of course, led defenseman in scoring then for Phoenix with 2 goals and 5 points in 7 games. And this probably would have been coming up to the start of his Iron Man streak, though playoffs notwithstanding. Early in his Iron Man streak, anyway, if I'm doing my math correctly. Other than that, rounding out the Phoenix's top 10, you have Martin Hansel, Vernon Fiddler, Taylor Pyatt, and Adrian O'Coin as well. So, anyway, Lauri Korpikoski, always thought that was a fun hockey name. He's in there as well. And Matthew Schneider, tail end of his career, having a cup of coffee in Phoenix, as was Robert Lang. My goodness, kind of a who's who there of NHL veterans. So, and Ed Jovanovski as well. Anyways, let's get this going here. This is Five Dice Hockey, created by Martin Kay. And yeah, let's play it out here again. This series is already 5 games old. So, how this is played, we're going to take 2 minutes off here to get things started. And right away, we're going to get a goal. So, we look here. This is a goal here. 1, 4, 6. And the 3 means that the Phoenix Coyotes here on the road. I want to see it go back to Phoenix for game 7, just so I can say, and just in case it doesn't, I'll say it now. Jobbing.com Arena. Is that not like the worst? There are some pretty bad stadium names out there. I know in Colorado, for instance, their arena was renamed Ball Arena instead of the Pepsi Center or whatever. You know, people poked fun at that Ball Arena. But jobbing.com, like in a pro wrestling sense, you know, if you're a jobber, if you're jobbing, the idea of jobbing is like you're folding, you're throwing it or whatever. Jobbing.com Arena was Phoenix's home. Poor Phoenix. I mean, now they're at the Gila River Arena, but they're not even really wanted there. So anyway, it's a 1-0 game for Phoenix. So now that I've, you know, poked fun at them, I can announce that, yeah, Phoenix is winning. We'll say that Volski got that goal assisted by Stempniak. couple of guys who played, I think, under 20 games in the regular season and both produced quite well. Anyway, three more coming off the clock here now. We're up to minute five. And with a 2:54, kind of a narrowish miss there. That would have been the Senators' goal had that been 2:11 or under. Phoenix here, because they're on the road, it's 1:62, Ottawa 2:11. Should there be a game seven, Ottawa has 1:65 on the road and Phoenix is 2:22. Anyway, another minute coming off the clock now. With a 2:56, it means that we just keep rolling. And we're going to stay in the same minute, however, and look at this here. With a 1:45 in the two, we're looking at a 2-0 Phoenix lead, and Phoenix up 3-2 in the series. So we'll credit Matthew Lombardi with that goal. We'll say maybe Keith Yandle set him up, fed it to him in the slot, and we'll keep going here. Where we get another minute, we're going to get our... I thought for some reason I saw six. I guess this is the six that I had seen. Had this been a green six, there would have been a turnover, possibly even a rare event. Anyway, we're going to stay in the same minute. Look at this. Couple of goals here. A couple of quick goals. So Phoenix really liking it right now. Fans in Ottawa must be very disappointed. Or in Kanata, rather, for that matter. Anyway, 3-0 Phoenix here. We are barely 7 minutes into it. So this could be over fast. That will also help in ushering the time along. But we get a turnover here as well with a 6:24. And it would have been Phoenix's chance. So this is a chance for Ottawa to finally get on the board themselves before they get too far behind and it gets too late. So the Senators here, the follow-up scoring chance, because that's a white four, that means that I also advance time on this chance and allow the possibility of a second turnover and or a rare event. So it's going to be 4:64 and nothing other than advancing the time 2 minutes. So we carry on here. We're going to get another four off the clock, though. We're up to minute 17 now in the period. And again, I see the green four, so I just keep on going. Green is go. Two more off the clock. And again, with the green three means that we don't need to really check any further. Oftentimes, you're just checking the two dice. So here, 2 minutes into the second period now. And again, with another green three. And we're going to take three more off the clock here. So we're up to minute five here in period two now. And we just keep going. Phoenix, they're up 3-0 now. Brizgalov. I don't envy Ottawa trying to score, you know, at least thrice on Brizgalov here in the game's remainder. Anyway, two more minutes coming off the clock now, up to minute seven. And we have another turnover here with a 6:55. So the 6:55 and the four. This is going to be a chance for Phoenix to go up by four. And we advance time on this opportunity. So they don't, but 4 minutes come off the clock, which benefits Phoenix anyway in this case. Let's see here. So four more off the clock now. So we're up to 15. And again, that 3:13 means that we can just keep on going here. Where we get two more off the clock now, 17. So we're late in the period, late in the second period, rather. Ottawa is really running out of time in this one. And got to pay attention here. And so, yeah, it's this could be over almost before it starts by the feels of things. Anyway, so final minute of the second period, and I keep rolling high in the green, which high-ish, which does not benefit Ottawa. So into the third period, we... Nope, not quite. I spoke too soon. Let me try that again. So... into the third period, we're 2 minutes in here to the third, and the green five just tells me to keep on going. And we're going to get a turnover here, but we're going to advance 4 minutes before doing so. And I try to look at this one last. I try to suspend the, I don't know, the drama or whatever, carry the suspense, keep myself in suspense. Anyway, so turnover here. So this turnover will go Ottawa's way with a 6:25. Again, it means that I have to advance time. And I don't have to check the red on this one. It's going to be an Ottawa chance. Ottawa, they don't do anything with it. And in the 4:16. So we're just going to keep on going here. But we have to take 3 minutes off the clock now. So we're up to minute nine here. 11 minutes to go in the game. Could Brizgalov end this one with a shutout and end it in style? Another 3 minutes come off the clock now. And again, the green five. Okay, another couple of minutes here. But it looks like we're going to get a goal. We have a 1:64. Oh, that's not quite a goal. That's actually not quite. I hope none of those were higher than 1:64. Wouldn't matter anyway. Phoenix is winning this game. But the 1:64 means maybe Phoenix hit the post or something. So 6 minutes to go in the game. Ottawa's got a lot to make up for here and little time in which to do it. So 2 more minutes coming off the clock now. 4 to go in the game. What is going on in Ottawa? Another 3 minutes. Now they're down to the final minute. I need to start rolling a lot of blue ones and goals to follow. For the Senators. That's it. That does it. So Brizgalov shuts Ottawa out of the series. Phoenix, let me grab a marker here just to kind of make it official. Phoenix, now they do not lead. It's not leads 3-2. Phoenix wins this series 4-2. So So ushering in, I guess they become the fourth team to advance to the second round. The next series that I'm going to do is the Vancouver Canucks and the Colorado Avalanche. Vancouver is up 3-2 in that series as well. So that one as well will just be 2 games maximum, and could end up being just the one game like this one here. And that should be a really good one, actually. That was a good. This was a really good series as well. I meant to say prior to the game, but forgot to that. Phoenix took a 1-0 lead, but then Ottawa, the series lead changed a couple of times, is what I mean. Phoenix was up 1-0, then Ottawa was up 2-1, and then Phoenix obviously headed into this up 3-2 in the series. So this was a pretty good series while it lasted without having a game seven. Game six, somewhat anticlimactic, but I mean, you know, if you're a Coyotes fan or a fan of just good goaltending in general, then you have to appreciate Brizgalov's shutout performance here, catapulting his team into the second round, I guess, in style, we could say. So, anyways, anytime, any consideration you give to anything like this, well, it's never expected. It's always appreciated. Cheers, thanks, and bye for now.